So the cheapest place to study medicine in Europe is actually Russia. That is because the Russian government subsidizes the education of medicine by up to 80% or 90%. So last year alone, the government allocated about 35 billion rubles, which is about $500 million, to help higher institutions cope with the economic crisis that was caused by COVID-19. So applying to study in Russia is a very simple process. You only need to have your high school certificate and your international passport. You send it to the school's website or the agency which helps you to submit, and just like that, you get your admission. Are these all the books I really need to become a doctor?
No, these are the books needed for the first week.
So the good things about studying in Russia are: one, the education is very cheap, and two, your degree will be recognized all over the world by organizations like the World Health Organization and UNESCO. That means you can work in any country after graduation. So in this video, we're going to be giving you one, how you can apply to Russian universities, how you can apply for scholarships in Russian universities, and then three, the cost of study in Russian universities. So we have already made a video about how to study in Russia, and this is going to be like the part two of that video, because we're going to be giving you more tips and easier ways to apply to study in Russia. So before we get into the application process, let's first tell you a little about studying medicine in Russia. Studying medicine in Russia involves two languages. You can either study in English language or in Russian language. But let me warn you guys, the English medium in Russia is not as advanced as in other European countries, because they still use translators and they don't have the good textbooks and all. And another disadvantage of studying in English language is that you're separated into a group of international students, and you don't mix with the Russian students, and you don't get the opportunity to study much about Russian culture. So students usually stay in the dormitories. A very few of them decide to rent apartments outside, but it's way cheaper to stay in the dormitories because it costs about 1,500 rubles, or about $14 a month, to stay in the hostels, whereas it costs about $500 a month to rent some of these apartments outside the hostel. And for the feeding options, students can either eat outside, that is eat in restaurants, or decide to cook for themselves. Russia is an agriculturally sufficient country, so you don't have to worry about food. Food is very cheap here. Yeah, you can spend about $100 a month on food, but that is nothing compared to other European countries where people spend about $500. But I would recommend you trying to cook on your own, because a lot of students came here without knowing how to cook, and now they cook better than they did when they first came, and I'm gonna do that again. And for the healthcare aspect, students usually pay about $100 every month to get insurance, that is medical insurance, and you can be treated for free if it's an emergency and an ambulance has been called, but basically it's very cheap. I don't think if you don't get seriously sick, you don't have to worry about anything about healthcare. So if you don't get seriously sick, you don't have to worry about the cost of healthcare, because you only need to go to the hospital, present your insurance, and get treated, and then maybe you can buy some few drugs that are not expensive depending on what is disturbing you, what's wrong with you. And one thing I forgot to mention is that the dormitories provide free Wi-Fi. So to apply for a scholarship position to study in Russia is very simple. You can simply contact the Russian embassy in your country, or Russian consulate, some of it call it, you know. And then you ask them if they have scholarship slots for your country, and if they say they have scholarship slots available, you ask them if you can write the exams, and if you pass the exams, they call you for an interview. If you pass the interview, they invite you over for documentation, and then just like that, you get... No, you're not done yet. You actually need to go through the Ministry of Education of your country, and if they select you, because sometimes they do this grading according to your high school result. If you have a high school result that is very good, you might have a good advantage. But the scholarship spots are limited, because every year Russia gives just 14,000 of these, 18,000 of these positions to foreign countries. Yeah.
So if you want to apply for a self-funded study in Russia, forget the grammar. When you want to pay for your tuition, you can either apply directly to the university or use the more popular option by admission agencies. So Russian universities, they mostly depend on admission agencies. And what do these admission agencies do? They collect and translate your documents and do a lot more. Which brings us to the sponsor of this video.
Russian
Education
Center
Rec
is
the
best
admission
agency
for
foreign
students
who
want
to
study
in
Russia.
To start, visit www.eduinrus.com.
See you in Russia.
Bye!
So this agency helps you to get admission in Russia, helps you to obtain your visa, and also picks you up from the airport on arrival. They also help you get a SIM card and a bank account, and they help with a lot of other things until you can speak Russian properly. Like, look at me, I can say it's drastic. So if you're interested in their services, please comment below. I will give you their contact. The cost of studying in Russia is actually very affordable compared to other European countries. Like we said before, earlier in the video, the government subsidizes up to 90%. So if you want to study in Russian, the cost of that is about 160,000 rubles, which is $2,000. So if you want to study in English, the price range is about $4,000 to $12,000, depending on the city you go to. Remember that Moscow and St. Petersburg are very expensive.
So guys, that was it for today's video. Thank you guys a lot for watching, and if we didn't bore you to death with this video, please subscribe to the channel and please like the video too. And if you want to study in Russia, please comment below and I will reply you personally. I'll usually reply all the comments because I don't have a lot of followers right now. So if you want us to be friends, this is your chance. And I'm going to be putting my Instagram and Amarachi's Instagram so that you can contact us if you have any questions. And if you are the type that doesn't like using Instagram, you can contact us via email. You can check it on the channel. Sorry, I'm being boring you right now, but don't worry. So if you don't like Russia and you want to study in another country, you can check out this video we made about studying in Germany. Or if you're a doctor and you have graduated, you are now a doctor and you want to work in Luxembourg, which is the highest paying country for doctors, you can check out this video on how to work in Luxembourg as a doctor. See you next time. Thank you for watching.